Hello everyone. In this tutorial, I am going to show you step by step how to install MySQL database server latest version on Windows 10. MySQL is an open source cross-platform relational database management server. It was first developed by a Swedish company and later it was acquired by Oracle Corporation. MySQL is offered in two editions, the Community Server Edition and the Enterprise Server Edition. In this tutorial, I am going to show you how to install the MySQL Community Server Edition. So the first thing we need to do is go to the MySQL Database Server download page. So on your search engine, type something like this, MySQL Server Community Edition download, and click on the first link. So on this page, make sure you are on the platform Microsoft Windows, and then you get some options for download. You can download zip archive, or you can click here to download an MSE installer. I'm going to go with the MSE installer option, so I'm going to click here, and on this page download the MSE installer file, which is this one that has 439 megabytes. Click on download, and then it's going to ask you either to log in or to sign up to the MySQL website, but you don't have to do that. If you don't want to log in or sign up, just click here on no thanks, just start my download, and your download is going to start shortly. I'm going to cancel this because I have already downloaded MySQL database server. So under downloads, I have here MySQL installer, right click on it and select install, and the installer is going to start in a few moments. If you get this user account control confirmation, just click yes. So on this first screen of the installer, you get to choose a setup type. You have five options: developer default, server only, client only, full, and custom. So with the developer default option, you can use it to create a development machine. You can use this option to install the components which are required only for application development, like MySQL Server, MySQL Shell, MySQL connectors, etc. So here you have the list of components included in this option: MySQL Server, the Shell, the Router, MySQL Workbench, and MySQL for Visual Studio, and MySQL connectors. You have also examples and tutorials and documentation. With server only, it's clear that you will only get server components installed. You will not have client components. With client only, it's the other way around. You will only get client components. You will not get server components. So for example, in this option, you have MySQL Workbench, but you will not have it in this option. In this option, you have MySQL Server, but you will not have it in this option. You have also the full option, which installs all the components, all the features, everything: client components, server components, everything. With custom option, you get to choose which components you want to install. You can have, for example, a machine that has server components and some client components. if you want to. For this installation, I'm going to choose the full option because I want everything to be installed on this machine. Click Next. Here it says that the selected path already exists, but never mind, just click Next. Here the installer is giving us some warnings, but we can continue the installation without installing Visual Studio. I do have it installed already, but it's not a problem. You don't have to have it. So click Next. And if you get prompted, just click Yes to say that you want to continue. On this page, you get the list of products that are going to be installed. So it's going to include everything, client components and server components. Click Execute to start the installation. If you are using a web-based installer, the installer is going to download all the products and then install them. But this is an offline installer. It should have all the components already. So it's just going to install them. So let's give it a few minutes to finish installing all these products. Clearly, these products are going to be installed one by one from top to bottom. Now that all the components of MySQL database have been installed, click Next. And here we are on the product configuration page, and we will be walking through a configuration wizard for each of these components: the MySQL server, the MySQL router, and samples and examples. Click Next. So for these options, I'm going to leave everything to default. So default port for MySQL is 3306, and the config type is development computer. If you are on a server computer or a dedicated computer, make sure you choose the appropriate option. Click Next. For the authentication method, I'm going to keep this to default, which is use strong password encryption for authentication, and click Next. Here I'm going to set the password for the root account. So it's saying here that password strength is medium, but it doesn't matter because this is a development machine. Click Next. You can add a user here, but I'm not going to do that for the moment. On the Windows Service Configuration page, you can choose a name for your MySQL service. I'm going to leave it to default, which is MySQL 80. And you can also specify which account the Windows service, this service is going to run as. You can either choose it to run it as a standard system account or another custom user. I'm going to leave it to the standard system account and click Next. But you can have a service account that is running MySQL service, so you can specify it here. If you have a service account in your Active Directory, you can specify it here with its password. Now this configuration that we have chosen is going to be applied. So just click execute and allow it to be applied. During the configuration, this initializing database, this step may take a long time to finish. So just be patient. When all the configurations have been applied, click next or click finish. If you have chosen to install all the components of MySQL Server, MySQL installer moves to samples and example screen. Click next. This page is for the MySQL router configuration. I'm going to leave everything to default and click next, click finish. Click next again. And this time it's the samples and examples installation. Here you need to type the password for the root user that you have set during the configuration. Check, click on check. If the password is correct, you will see here connection successful. Click next. And click execute to allow the samples and examples to be installed. It's going to take a few moments for this to finish. Once the samples and examples have been installed, click on finish. The installer continues to the product configuration screen. On this screen, you can see that the installation of MySQL Server and samples and examples has been completed successfully. Click next. Once the installation completes, you can copy the installation logs on the clipboard to review it later. If you want to start using MySQL right away, you can select the Start MySQL Workbench after setup and Start MySQL Shell after setup. Then click Finish. So I'm going to copy to clipboard the logs, create a new file, call it MySQL logs, and paste the logs here for review later. Then I'm going to keep these two options checked and click finish. And this should start the MySQL shell and MySQL workbench as well. Once the installation completes, let's connect to the server and execute the first MySQL query. Just like SQL Server Management Studio, MySQL Workbench is a development tool which is used to query the database and create database objects. On the MySQL Workbench welcome screen, you can see the list of MySQL connections available. We have not configured yet any other connections. That's why you are only able to see the local instance MySQL 80. Click on it to open the new query editor window. It's going to ask you for the password. Type the password. You can check this option to save the password in Vault and click OK. First, let's create a simple database on MySQL Server. So write the following query in the query editor window and click on execute. The query is create database demo DB. And click on this button right here to execute this query. As you can see here, create database demo DB. If you go here to the schemas tab and refresh, you can see the demo database. You can also see the Sakila database and the world database, which are sample databases as well. In this tutorial, we have learned step by step how to install MySQL database server latest version and on Windows 10. And we have managed to run our first query on MySQL workbench. I hope that you have enjoyed this tutorial, and thank you for watching.